Boys, what are you watching?
I got one. Murder Mountain. Scary. It's a 6-part documentary on Netflix. It was originally, I believe, on television, if I'm not mistaken. But it's about the illegal growing of legal marijuana in a town in Northern California that's way, way, way up in the hills. And basically how these kind of yokels for a long time were running these illegal marijuana farms, but kind of got away with it because they were up in the mountains. And then other people come in, and it's a documentary. And like, I think a total of like probably 4 or 5 people get killed in it. And tons of missing people and all this stuff. But it's a quick watch. I started it like yesterday and finished it today. So Murder Mountain on Netflix, I will definitely recommend if you're into like docuseries.
Gamer, what have you been watching?
So 2 things. So I think, Boomy, you mentioned this last week. Waco on Netflix.
Yes.
Yeah, I watched that this week. Was awesome. Taylor Kitsch is awesome, and that Michael Shannon is unbelievable.
I got that on my list. Is it giving me a rating out of 10?
Ooh. So it's kind of like, all right, so it's a mini series, obviously. It's like there's 6 episodes. Because it's a historical event, I mean, I put it up in the 8, probably like 8.3. Okay. Like it is pretty good. There are some storylines that were kind of hard to follow, I thought, but it was like, it just blew my mind as I was watching it, like some of the stuff. Like I did some research for like the first episode because I'm nosy and I want to know what's going to go on. But they did such a nice job with it. And there's so many twists too that like they have such good information because they have it on both sides. They have somebody who was on the inside of it.
Is that the Brandy Vidians?
Yes. So they have somebody who was part of that. Yeah. And then they have somebody who was from the FBI. And those two kind of like, they tell a story in there, and then so you get a good view of both sides and what it was like. So that's pretty good. And then I had to watch, I say I had to, but I watched the Central Park 5 documentary.
Yes, that is When They See Us or whatever.
Yeah, so it's
that is amazing.
It is really good. So I would also recommend that. Ken Burns was the one who put that all together. Really good.
Oh, it's so sad.
Yeah. It is. It's really sad, but it's really interesting. It just really makes you think about today's legal system and, you know, the injustices that we have today still and back then, because this took place in, I want to say, was it the early 90s, late 80s, one of the two?
Yeah, but, yeah. Like 89, I think.
Yeah, so it makes you wonder, like, this has been going on for a long time. We still see that today.
Yeah, that was amazing. I remember why I'd seen that come up on my thing, and I remembered I had watched that back maybe in the winter. But yeah, that was very, very well done. And it's
another, I don't know if you guys have been watching this. I've never watched this. Comedians in Cars Having Coffee. I think that's what it's called with Jerry Seinfeld. It's really cool. My dad was watching it, so I kind of got into it. It has like Kevin Hart, Jimmy Fallon, Seth Rogen. Like a bunch of comedians, and it's just he tries to like critique the car around the specific the guest, and then he'll go get a car or whatever, and he'll pick them up in the car, and they'll go have coffee, and it's just really interesting to. First of all, I'm just a big Jerry Seinfeld fan in general. I'm a big Seinfeld guy, the show, and it's just kind of cool to get the stories from him, but also the stories from the other people, and they just feel so comfortable being around Jerry Seinfeld and being able to talk, and it's just I think it's. It's one of the I hate to say this, but I'm not a fan of really any of the late. I mean, I like Jimmy Fallon and whatever, but like I'm not really a fan of any of the late night. Like I'm actually more of a fan of the David Spade show that he does, Lights Out. But I think like the interviewer process or whatever is just awesome on there. Like it's just the way he like. The questions he asks and the way he can like he already has stories with a lot of the people, like it's very interesting. So
yeah, he can relate to those guys because he's a comedian too. It makes it that much better.
You get stories from Jerry Seinfeld every episode, so that's always they're
fairly like fast.
You get through a season fairly quickly. I think there's like 3 or 4 seasons. Maybe more, but it's a good show.